Hello, my name is Kristin Johnson. I'm originally from the United States of America. I currently work here at ELSI, and today I'm going to teach you about meteorites. Meteorites themselves are actually the products of different kinds of planetary, asteroidal, and lunar objects. An asteroid is just a particular conglomeration of loosely connected rocky material, whereas planets are differentiated bodies such as Mars, Mercury, and then rocky moons end up being a source for meteorites as well, things such as our own moon that orbiting the Earth. Whenever thinking about meteorite formation, the small fragments of rock that can come off of these particular objects are originally meteoroids. And meteoroids then have to go through the process of transitioning and being deposited onto the surface of a planetary body, such as our Earth, before being designated as meteorites. The classification of meteorite, though, is sometimes even incorrectly designated by professionals. For example, meteors, often confused with meteorites, are actually just small pieces of rocky material that burns up in our atmosphere and never makes it to the surface of the planet. Meteor crater in Arizona actually makes this mistake, referring to their crater as a meteor crater as opposed to a meteorite crater. Another object to consider in a solar system is a comet. Comets themselves are rocky bodies surrounded with ice and volatiles. That particular ice ends up burning off as it makes its rotation through an orbit in the solar system. And comets have their own particular fixed orbits, and when they come closer to the sun, end up burning off the ice and volatiles. Meteorites themselves, being made from all these different kinds of original planetary bodies, actually have different kinds of compositions. For example, there are metal meteorites that are a result of differentiated bodies, or bodies that have a core, mantle, and exterior breaking up and then forming into these larger fragments after they break apart. The core would show up as a metal-containing meteorite. It would be easy to find on Earth because it would be very different from the kinds of soil and plants that we actually have on the surface. But if you were to find instead a meteorite that had a stony composition, it would look exactly the same as an actual rock on Earth. And if you were to find it out in a natural environment that contains dirt, you wouldn't actually be able to find that meteorite. So instead, you have to look for those type of objects on large homogeneous locations, places like the desert and the Serengeti or Antarctica with large ice sheets, where very different composition meteorites would actually condense and then be able to be easily spotted. So thank you very much for your attention. I hope that you learned a bit about meteorites.